Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Sunday, Solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Blessed be God the Father, and the only begotten Son of God, and also the Holy Spirit, for He has shown us His merciful love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing the true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading, a reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Ask now of the days of old, before your time, ever since God created man upon the earth, ask from one end of the sky to the other. Did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of fire, as you did, and live? Or did any god venture to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of another nation, by testings, by signs and wonders, by war, with strong hand, an obstructed arm, and by great terrors, all of which the Lord, your God, did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in the heavens above and on earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep His statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have long life on the land which the Lord your God is giving you forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own."
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
Upright is the word of the Lord, and all His works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made. By the breath of His mouth, all their host. For He spoke, and it was made. He commanded, and it stood forth.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear Him, upon those who hope for His kindness to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. May your kindness, O Lord, be upon us who have put our hope in you.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be His own.
Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, for those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you receive a spirit of adoption through whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with Him, so that we may also be glorified with Him. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, Alleluia. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
The 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had ordered them. When they all saw him, they worshipped, but they doubted. Then Jesus approached and said to them, All power in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, today we celebrate probably one of the most difficult mysteries to explain, actually, no? And yet, I think one of the most central mysteries of our faith. It's almost like it lies at the very core of our sense of community and even our sense of wholeness as a person, no? The mystery of the Trinity. Siguro yan yung isa pinakamahirap na pagnilayan, ano? Sa, kahit nung nag-aaral kami ng theology, talagang very challenging yung Santismo Trinidad, ano? But let me now invite you to reflect on the gospel reading and also the readings for this Sunday, the very beautiful readings. Of course, this is now the reading that is the narrative of the Ascension. So let me bring you back to that beautiful meditation of St. Ignatius of Loyola in the Spiritual Exercises, the meditation on the mystery of the Incarnation. Nabahagi ko na ito sa inyo, di ba? Yung kinukwento ko na sabi ni San Ignacio, tingnan mo, panuurin mo yung Santismo Trinidad, no? Ama, Anak, at Espiritu Santo na nakaupo doon sa langit, sa kanilang mga trono, na pinapanood nila kung anong nangyayari sa mundo. Yung patayan, yung mga kasalanan, yung injustice. So watch the Trinity watching what is going on in the world and to humanity. And because of the evil that they saw, they decide, okay, together, the Trinity, they decide to mission the Son. And there you have the mystery of the Incarnation. Siguro yun yung unang punto, no? Na ang Santismo Trinidad ang nagpasya, no? Na isugo, imisyon ang Diyos Anak, no? Upang tayo ay maligtas. At bahagi ng kanilang mission ay yung pagiging pagkakatawan tao ng Panginoon. And for me, that is a very powerful description of the Holy Trinity, that together they decide to save the world. No, it is a three persons in one God. They decide to save the world through the Incarnation by sending the Son to carry out the mission. No, that first point. No, yung sa napakagandang meditation ni Saint Ignatius. And coming from that, no, to realize that all mission emanates from the decision of the Trinity, we come full circle now, and this is the second point, in the Gospel of the Ascension. That now Christ says, I am going back. Babalik ako, di ba? Doon sa aking original glory. I'm going back to the Father and the Spirit, no? To join the Trinity once more. He ends His time here on earth. So yung pangalawang puntong yon ay siguro maganda din pagnilayan natin na the Trinity now, they come full circle. From the sending of the Son, it is now the return of the Son, accomplishing the mission. And tandaan natin na yan din ang galaw ng mission ng buhay natin, no? We always come full circle. I think that is something that is a very good sign if we are following God's will and mission for us. That always, no, there is always that experience of coming full circle. No? Kung saan tayo nagsimula, babalik din tayo doon, no? Na meron tayong nagawa na, no? Na higit na pabuti natin ang mundo, na pabuti natin ang buhay natin, ang buhay ng ibang tao. Na mahalaga na ang Diyos na nagbigay sa atin ng inspirasyon ng ating misyon, doon din magtatapos ang misyon. Sabi nga natin, di ba, that what God started in us, we pray that He sustains in us and brings to completion. That is coming full circle. Siguro yung pangalawang punto ng pagninilay na yon, ano? At kaakibat niyang pangalawang punto niya, nais ko lang magbigay din ng tip, ano? Yung sinasabi rin ni Saint Ignatius, sinasabi tungkol kay Saint Ignatius na siya ay merong great ability to do extraordinary things for God. And yet at the same time, with that great courage and energy comes constancy in seeing the task to fulfillment and the prudence to make sure it is accomplished. No? Constancy in pursuing the task and the prudence to complete the task. Yan din yung galaw ng Trinity, no? Through the Son and then the Spirit. And perhaps we could also reflect on that in our life, no? Yung ating masasabi natin kakayahan na gawin ang lahat para sa Diyos, pero mahalaga rin yung ating patuloy na pagpupunyagi sa pagsasabuhay niyan at yung ating discernment at pag-iingat, yung prudence na maisakatuparan yung pinagagawa ng Diyos. That second set of reflections. And then the third and final point is, if you notice, now that Christ comes full circle, the Trinity, they come full circle, it bears fruit in our mission. Now Christ asks us, on behalf of the Father and the Spirit, to continue the mission. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations. And in the name of the Trinity, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Spirit, again, no, it's the mark of the Trinity, no. And then also the Lord says, no, behold, I am with you always to the end of the age. That is now the movement of the Spirit in our life. So today, let us pray for these graces. Let us pray na mabuhay sa atin ang biyaya at ang pagkatao ng Santismo Trinidad. That our lives be integrated by the grace, the love, and the presence of the Trinity in our lives. Not only our lives individually, but most especially our communities, our families, our communities, our church, that we may become, as I mentioned before, from the book that from an Italian book, that we may become icons of the Trinity in the world today. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
God is our Creator and Father. He has given us His Son to be our life. Through His Holy Spirit, let us raise our voices as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our church leaders be docile to the voice of the Holy Spirit, faithful to the way of Christ, and diligent in listening to the divine word and in approaching the wellspring of grace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Holy Spirit strengthen the leaders of our country in their commitment to promote justice, peace, and truth, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May consecrated men and women show forth their love for the poor and the oppressed. May they be one with those in need and abound in works of mercy. May they be compassionate toward all, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May those who are suffering because of sickness, poverty, and difficulty in their relationships be sustained by the love of God and through the care of their families and friends, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Lord bless the efforts and initiatives of all the parishioners who compose the parish and BECs. May the spirit of collaboration bring us into a fruitful communion with the Father. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May our departed brothers and sisters be welcomed into the kingdom of eternal life. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And together again, let us pray for the coming 2022 elections. God our Father, as we prepare for our 2022 elections, we put our trust in your promise that you will send us leaders after your own heart and spirit. Lord Jesus, inspire all who seek office to be servant leaders who will put the greater good of the greater majority, especially the poor, the marginalized, and the vulnerable, above any personal or group interests. Servant leaders who will seek office to genuinely serve and not to be served. Servant leaders of integrity and compassion. Holy Spirit, enlighten our minds and hearts that we may see clearly the needs of our people and what candidates promise and their ability to fulfill these. That we choose rightly the leaders who will truly lead and serve, leaders who are after your own heart and spirit, leaders who will unite and lead us to do what is for the greater good of the greater majority and what is for your greater glory. Father, Son, and Spirit, you are the God of life and love, the Lord of history. Be with us in this time of preparation for the coming elections. Amen. Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
And again, together with the Church, as the Pope requested, let us pray to our Blessed Mother, asking her to pray to put an end to this pandemic. Remember, O Most Gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thy intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, we turn to thee, O Virgin of Virgins, our Mother. To thee we come, before thee we stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not our petitions, but in thy mercy hear and answer us. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord, our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit. So that confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by the angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot, at this moment, receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God of mercy and compassion, we come to you in the midst of our sufferings due to the COVID-19 pandemic and ask for your healing love to overcome our fear of sickness and death and to restore our hope and faith. We pray for all health workers who are the frontliners in serving and healing the victims of the virus. Protect them and grant them your inspiration to sustain them in body, mind, heart, and spirit. And for those who fell ill and passed on, reward them with eternal life with you and consolation for their loved ones. For all who work tirelessly to serve the needs of the people, keep them safe too and grant them your guidance, most especially our leaders, to selflessly work for the common good and find meaning in their service. We pray for the victims of this virus, the dying, and those who have died in agony and loneliness. Let their suffering be their participation in the suffering of your Son that redeemed us. For all who are infected, heal them and grant them full recovery. Continue to guide our experts tasked to find effective vaccines and cures for this virus. Use them as instruments in your healing hands. We ask all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son and our divine healer, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael, the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul, as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy.
Amen.
May he turn his countenance towards us and give us his peace.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon us and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Go in the peace and love of the Trinity.
Thanks be to God.
Again, thank you to all our partners in Alay Kapwa Stewardship Fund. And our total as of this week is 18,936,637.39. Again, we will next week, we will give you the breakdown, this coming week, not on Sunday, but during the week, maybe Saturday. We'll give you the breakdown of the months and also report to you already the programs that we have funded and how much has been spent. We'd like you to begin to consider to become a regular steward by sharing. The amount doesn't matter, but it's really the commitment to give monthly or quarterly or biannually or yearly. But to become an Alay Kapwa steward, especially in supporting the anti-poverty programs of Caritas Philippines. So again, have a good Sunday and please join us for Journeys of Hope with Brother Jun Banaag, Dr. Love. So thank you and have a good Sunday.
Sa pamamagitan ng ating Alay Kapwa program, sa panahon ng kalamidad gaya ng bagyo, lindol, at iba pang paghihirap sa buhay ng ating mga kapatid, ang Alay Kapwa program ng ating simbahan ay laging handang tumulong at tumugon. Kamakailan lamang po, tayo ay naglaan. ng 5 million pesos para sa kindness stations or community pantries ng mga social action centers ng 50 dioceses sa Luzon, Visayas at Mindanao. Ito po ay galing sa inyong mga donations na pakunti-kunting ibinigay sa pamamagitan ng ating panawagan dito sa ABS-CBN. Kapwa ko, pananagutan ko.